Just what was so sweet about Blake Shelton's wedding vows to Gwen Stefani? Where did they finally buy a home together? Keep watching for what you need to know about this power couple. Gwen Stefani joined the cast of The Voice as a judge in 2014. Although both she and Blake Shelton were married to other people at the time, they built a steady friendship that became the foundation for their relationship. While Shelton reflected on his time on The Voice, he said the greatest thing that ever happened to him on the show was, of course, meeting Stefani. Although some fans of The Voice may think differently, Stefani assured everyone in an interview with Cosmopolitan that she and Shelton actually started off as friends. Stefani said, "We were laughing our heads off when we saw the blind auditions. I love NBC, but they for sure edited stuff to look like we were flirting. They chose to run with that story before anything was even real. I hardly knew him." But when the pair performed Hotline Bling together on The Tonight Show in October 2015, the chemistry was pretty impossible to deny. A month later, Us Weekly confirmed the two were an item. Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton were both going through very painful, very public divorces at the same time during the summer of 2015. Blake Shelton divorced his wife of 5 years, Miranda Lambert, and Gwen Stefani split up with her husband, Gavin Rossdale, after 13 years of marriage. Shelton explained to Billboard that Stefani had approached him with tears in her eyes and asked to speak with him alone after he shared the news of his split with Lambert with the cast and crew of The Voice. Stefani shared that she was going through something similar to Shelton, and the singers kept in contact through emails about once a week, then 3 times a week, then every day until they eventually exchanged phone numbers. Shelton opened up and said, "Gwen saved my life. Who else on earth could understand going through a high-profile divorce from another musician?" It's no secret that Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton love music and each other, so on several occasions, they've decided to combine the two and record a few duets. Happy Anywhere was released in July 2020, and the couple debuted Nobody But You in 2019. Go Ahead and Break My Heart came out in 2016, and the duo released their holiday jam, You Make It Feel Like Christmas, in 2017, just to name a few. However, although Shelton and Stefani have recorded quite a few duets, the couple has only written 3 songs together. In an interview with Chelsea Handler, Stefani explained the process of writing You Make It Feel Like Christmas. Although the pop singer released an entire Christmas album of the same name, she and Shelton only collaborated on the song after Shelton came up with the chorus one day on his tour bus. Stefani said,
"It's like it's crazy to me. Like, he's so talented and he doesn't really write that often."
Shelton admitted she was right.
"She is constantly on my ass about, I should be writing more songs. How come you don't write more songs, you know?" And I have gotten lazy about it over the years.
It's not hard to tell that Blake Shelton is in love with Gwen Stefani, but he's also extremely committed to her 3 boys, Apollo, Zuma, and Kingston. A source told People that Shelton even asked for the boys' permission before he proposed to Stefani. The boys were all present at Shelton and Stefani's wedding, too. Although Shelton has been candid about how being a father is no easy job, his own stepfather set a good example for him. In an interview with The Ride with Kimo and Heather, Shelton explained, "I have a stepfather in my life who is one of my heroes. I love my stepfather and I look up to him, and he's like a father to me." Later on in the interview, Shelton sweetly shared, "I can't imagine my life without these kids now." For Gwen Stefani's birthday in 2016, Blake Shelton bought her possibly the greatest gift ever. Stefani shared on her Instagram that Shelton had given her a horse and that she named the animal Halo. Shelton shared with Entertainment Tonight, "Gwen, she loves riding and she loves horses. It's actually so funny that people are so shocked by that. But if you can name me one girl on the planet that doesn't love horses or just think that they are beautiful." For Valentine's Day in 2017, Shelton showed off his romantic side yet again in a goofy clip for The Voice that was played on Today. Holding a teddy bear, Shelton said, "Gwen, I got this to show you how much I care about you." Stefani laughed as she watched the clip and exclaimed, "He's a dork, it's so funny." While too much quality time during quarantine may have driven some couples apart, it seems like Blake Shelton and Gwen Stefani came out of that period more in love than ever before. The duo quarantined in Oklahoma, and they did a lot of the same things the rest of us did to pass the time. In a video for The Voice, Stefani revealed that she and Shelton learned how to make sourdough bread, planted flowers in their garden, and just did ordinary activities. Stefani said, "It was just like a lot of stuff that you kind of dream about doing, but you never have time to do." Stefani even gave Shelton a quarantine haircut, as shown on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. The Holla Back Girl singer cut the country star's hair during his interview with Fallon. And Shelton even requested that Stefani shave Fallon's initials into his hair for the show. When Gwen Stefani announced her return to The Voice in 2019, she admitted to The Talk that she was excited to be a judge again and said,
"I mean, Blake's my best friend, so I get to hang out with him at work, which is weird."
In an interview with Zane Lowe for Apple Music, Stefani continued to gush about Shelton and said, "We tell each other everything. I don't want to do anything without him. He's my homie." Stefani's sweet social media posts dedicated to the country singer regularly remind fans how happy she and Shelton are together. In a 2020 Instagram post for Shelton's birthday, Stefani shared a photo of her kissing his cheek and said, "Happy birthday, thank you for being my best friend." Although Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton don't write a lot of songs together, the No Doubt singer explained that Shelton is always willing to lend an ear when she needs advice about her music. In an episode of DJ Khaled's podcast, The First One, Stefani talked about how she collaborates with Shelton on her music like she used to with her No Doubt bandmates. She also revealed that she leaned on him a lot while planning her solo record. Stefani shared on the podcast, "Yesterday, Blake and I sat down and listened to, like, every song, which is a lot of songs, and just put our favorite stars by which ones. We definitely bounce off each other." When Stefani and Shelton co-wrote their first song together, Go Ahead and Break My Heart, the Rich Girl singer told Cosmopolitan that the songwriting process was very spontaneous. Stefani shared that Shelton had written most of the song and asked for her help to finish it while he was out of town. Stefani said, "As soon as he came back to town, he brought his guitar over. We were like, we wrote a song together. This is crazy." Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton were judges on The Voice for 5 non-consecutive seasons together, and it seems they love competing against one another. While anyone who watches The Voice knows that Shelton is a fierce competitor, the words he shared about Stefani during the 10th anniversary episode of the show were too sweet. He said, "I love it when she's here. She brings a very complicated element of competition for me in particular, but I love that. I love the challenge. Just knowing that she's there and she has my back is pretty cool." In a small ceremony at Blake Shelton's ranch in Oklahoma, he and Gwen Stefani finally tied the knot over the 4th of July weekend in 2021. The wedding ceremony took place in a chapel on Shelton's property that he built to commemorate their love. Even though their wedding day was already picture-perfect, Shelton took the day to a whole new level by writing a song for his vows. In a statement, Shelton said that he wrote the song, We Can Reach the Stars, with Craig Wiseman, and finally released it to the public November 5, 2021. In an Instagram post, Shelton got candid about the vulnerable song and said, "I'm really proud of We Can Reach the Stars, and I'm really honored to be with Gwen Stefani. That's why we got married in the first place. That's why we wear rings, because we want everyone to know. I'm thrilled to share this song with the world." After the happy couple spent months quarantining together at Blake Shelton's ranch in Oklahoma, they decided to put down roots together and buy their own family home in Los Angeles. According to Dirt, Gwen Stefani and Shelton bought their first home together for $13.2 million in 2020.
"I'm in a house with a way bigger celebrity."
The house reportedly extends over about 13,000 square feet, includes a home theater and a pool, and is located in a very private area. A source shared with Us Weekly, "They are truly happy as a family, and it's the new beginning Gwen needed." Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more list videos about your favorite celebrities are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.